What you just heard about me was a success story. A successful career spanning 4 decades, my expertise in counterterrorism, a few achievements, a few awards. But it wasn't always a smooth ride. It had its own share of trials and tribulations. There were failures, the big upsets, the challenges. Today, I'm going to talk to you about my failures. What comes to your mind when you hear about surgical strikes? Pride, patriotism, the bravery of the Indian Army soldier. But when I think of surgical strikes, I think of a depressing Sunday, 10 days before the strikes. When I was the co-commander in Srinagar, in charge of all the army deployed in Kashmir, Uri happened. You may recall that in a suicide attack on 18th of September 2016, 4 terrorists managed to sneak into an army camp at Uri, very close to the LOC, and killed 19 army soldiers. It was a black day for me. The loss of 19 young lives, and on my watch. I was also responsible to ensure that the line of control is not breached. Yet, it had happened. But didn't I overcome failures earlier in my life? If I was to single out the single biggest factor that helped me overcome failures in my life, it would be my positive attitude, the power of positive thinking. Now, how does one inculcate positive thinking, positive attitude? A lot of it comes from your beliefs, the values, your value system, your upbringing at home and office. When I was growing up as a child, I thanked my father for the values that I picked up from him. When I was growing up as a child, my father was an airman in the Indian Air Force, an aircraft engine mechanic. He was so good in his work that I saw his superiors trusting him beyond his brief. He also would relegate his personal comfort, his family life, to achieve the assigned task, often beyond the call of his duty. I saw him choosing the harder right instead of the easier wrong. That value system of confidence in one's own abilities, putting in sustained hard work to give one's best and leave the rest to the Almighty. Isn't that what Gita also teaches us? He would often explain an old saying to me, made very popular by Shah Rukh Khan in some Bollywood movie. Kehte hain agar kisi cheez ko dil se chaho, to sari kainat use tumse milane ki koshish mein lag jati hai. Translated, it means, when you will for something strongly, the whole universe will conspire to give it to you, unquote. Because it is when you steadily intend for something, when you will something strongly, it is then that your will and the divine will become one. In Hindu mythology, it is then that the Atma and Paramatma become one. So thank you, Dad, for that upbringing at home. As a professional, when I was commissioned as an army officer, I was allotted a unit. Everyone gets to stay in his own unit in the regiment. I was allotted the unit 8 Jackalai, 8th Battalion, the Jammu and Kashmir Light Infantry, a rare unit, which was raised as a volunteer force during the Indo-Pak operations of 1947-48. It had a rich history of valor and bravery in 65 war, in 71 war, and at the Siachen Glacier. I grew up amongst heroes. In infantry, for an infantry officer, his biggest aspiration, his dream, is to command the very battalion that you are commissioned in as a second lieutenant. When I became a colonel, I got the command of my own battalion. And our battalion had just moved into a very operationally active area in JNK at the line of control. And within a few days, I assumed the command of that battalion. It's a dream for an officer to command the battalion and also to be able to lead his men in battle, in operations. So that was a dream come true for me. Within 1 week, we had our first encounter with terrorists and we lost an officer. I felt shattered. Loss of a young major in front of my own eyes in an encounter with terrorists, it was such a blow for me personally, emotionally, and as a professional. I just couldn't sleep that night. I thought, how would I face his family? How would I face my own unit in which I had grown up for the last 2 decades? My own career was surely over, and I just couldn't sleep a wink that night. But then, closer to the dawn, a realization dawned on me that his martyrdom was not in vain. All the three terrorists were killed and not a single one escaped. Isn't that the ultimate purpose of a soldier's career? He was a hero. So next day, I collected my soldiers. I spoke to the men in my battalion. And this is what I said. Yesterday, we lost a brave officer who took a bullet in his chest while leading from the front. But all the three terrorists were eliminated. His bravery also saved the lives of some of our soldiers and locals. So how do we pay homage to such a hero? We pay homage to such a hero by eliminating more and more terrorists. Our battalion has such a rich history of bravery in all the operations. Look at what we did at the Siachen Glacier a decade ago, where also our first operational casualty, fatality was an officer. And see how we covered ourselves up in glory after that. We executed the highest attack in the world at 21,000 feet. Capture of Bana Top, winning one Paramveer Chakra, one Mahavir Chakra, and a host of other awards. We are going to do that again. We pay homage to Major Rohit Sharma by ensuring that not a single terrorist remains in our area of responsibility. Little did I know that my words would be prophetic. Over the next 3 years, my command tenure, we eliminated 106 terrorists in that area, which is a record of sorts in JNK till date. Thank you. In this positivity of creating a glimmer of hope, even in adverse circumstance, were sown the seeds of future successes to follow. Being positive in oneself is half the battle won. But to achieve success, this positivity has to be shared by the whole team, by the entire environment. When I was a major general, I was posted to the Northeast to raise a new counter-terrorism force of Assam Rifles, a paramilitary force. I was sorely disappointed. I was looking forward to a prestigious command of one of the divisions in JNK, my area of expertise. I felt I was being sidelined. But then that glimmer of hope, that silver lining in the dark cloud. And I thought to myself, a new structure has to be raised, a force comprising over 12,000 soldiers. But I had to first fight the demons within. I had to convince myself, and I thought, after all, I had been selected from amongst my peers to raise this structure. How many people would get the honor to start a new organization, a counter-terrorism force, set up new processes, and make it a vibrant operational body? So when I reached Shillong, And I met other officers, started arriving, officers posted to my headquarters who were there to assist me. I realized that I actually have a great team. We got everyone passionate about the fact that we were going to be remembered as founding fathers. We were going to be remembered as founding fathers forever. Then I set about visiting the remote outposts where troops were deployed. Assam Rifle soldiers were deployed. Remote outposts in far-flung areas in the jungles of the Northeast. The boys were doing a fine job there. When I went there, I was not content with briefings and presentations by commanders alone. I'd go meet the backroom boys, the cooks in the kitchen, the drivers of the fleet, go to the workshop floors, meet the mechanics, the cleaners, everyone. And I got everyone passionate about the fact that their contributions were equally important to the war effort. It was a teamwork, and their contributions mattered. That created such a groundswell of participative enthusiasm from bottom up. When the top-down enthusiasm from my headquarters met with this grassroots level enthusiasm from the units, it created such a positive spiral that everyone wanted to do his best. That feeling of trying to do his best was becoming contagious. Within a short while, we had two of our units, they achieved some operational successes. And when that happened, I convinced my superiors to fast-track the awards for them, for the deserving soldiers. Ah, the morale of my force knew no bounds. That a fledgling force had achieved such laurels so soon after its inception. All this created such a positive spiral that the enthusiasm to do well, to participate in all activities, to do well, became very contagious and infectious. And from the feeling that I was being sidelined as a major general, we went on to achieve great successes in this force. And this led eventually to my promotion as a lieutenant general. And I became the co-commander of the most prestigious corps of the Indian Army, the Chinar Corps at Srinagar. Thank you. And that is where Uri happened. That black day of Uri massacre. The loss of 19 lives of my soldiers. Over the years, the beliefs, the values that I had picked up from my father, the ability to see a silver lining in every dark cloud, to be able to stoke up a positive spiral even under adverse circumstances, and many other such life lessons helped us to create, helped us to plan the biggest revenge ever. To do something to the enemy that caused him much more hurt. And surgical strikes happened. All that positive attitude, that harnessing the power of positive thinking exponentially, paid off so well in the last and the biggest operation of my career that we did not have a single casualty amongst our soldiers. That was unbelievable. So before I step down, I'd like to salute the bravery of the brave hearts who carried out the sterling surgical strikes. Jai Hind. Thank you.